But may I give you a theory?
You can. You don't want the rest of the odds.
I do, okay. But I think this will affect the odds.
Okay.
Mike Pence. I just don't think Mike Pence wrote this.
No, I don't either.
And maybe it's a setup. Maybe somebody is setting him up to look like the guy who did this. I don't know.
That's what I was thinking.
Okay. Mm-hmm. So here's... They reference the 25th Amendment. You have Donald Trump, who is already a caged animal, right?
Mm-hmm.
He is feeling very alone. He just gave an interview just last weekend where he talked about how alone he feels, okay? It's a lonely job in the first place. You're surrounded by enemies, always busting you in the head. You're paranoid. We know he's a paranoid guy. You're paranoid as it is, and he has reason to be paranoid right now. And then you release this. What is that going to do besides bring out probably more erratic behavior?
Right.
Is this a possible setup to bring a more unstable president out so you would have more evidence of the 25th Amendment? If you got together in a group and you'd say, let's do that. The argument would be, we don't have enough evidence. We don't have enough people that would testify on this, this, and this. He'd have to do these things. Well, wouldn't this help?
And that's an insane game you're playing there.
Insane.
But you have to imagine, the end game is not an op-ed, right? Like, the end game is not, hey, I'm going to write something, and then maybe someday people will think better of me. I don't know. That seems hard to believe. And by the way, the lodestar thing, he used the word lodestar in the L-O-D-E-S-T-A-R in the op-ed. Lodestar means a star that leads or guides, especially a North Star, mm-hmm. one that serves as an inspiration.
Most people would use North Star or right. Polar Star.
And almost nobody, I've probably never heard anyone in my life use the word lodestar. Mm-hmm. So my first thought when I was reading that, I'm like, lodestar, who the heck uses that word? And I was like, the first thing I would do if I was at the White House is I'd be searching the internal email servers to see who's ever used the word lodestar. Because obviously, if you're writing this about yourself, you're going to make sure you don't use a word associated with you. If you have phrasing that you use all the time, you're not going to put it in your op-ed because everyone's going
to
notice it.
It'd be like me, right? Do your own homework or the world's about to come to an end.
Right.
You exactly. just don't put
they
that
know
in
it was
there.
Glenn.
Right.
So when you're doing something like this, you're going to make sure to not include something that's associated with you publicly. So I thought you got to search these email servers. Maybe somebody does use that privately.
They did.
I'm sure they did. However, what they found, what people have found so far, is that Mike Pence actually does use the word publicly often. And that to me screams somebody targeting Pence. Somebody who wants Pence out of there, out of the circle of trust, knows that Pence uses that word all the time. And is trying to go after him as part of this thing. I don't think
so. Let me say this: if that would be true, then what everything else this person wrote would be false, because Pence will be a moderating voice there.
Yes,
you know what I mean.
And all reports indicate he has been
right. Mm-hmm. So if you're trying to set Pence up or separate him from the president, you're not helping moderate things.
Yeah.
You're trying to upset the apple cart because Pence is blocking you from your access or your point of view with the president.
It could very well be, too, someone who might be an establishment figure, praises McCain in the op-ed.
Yeah.
Could be someone from that wing who doesn't like the sort of more conservative leanings of Pence.
Yes. Yes.
That's possible as well.
That's what I mean.
Yeah. So, I mean, minus 150 for Mike Pence is a terrible bet. I can't imagine it's actually him.
I can't either.